శ్రీ ముత్తవరపు వెంకటేశ్వరరావు కాలేజ్ ఆఫ్ ఇంజనీరింగ్ అండ్ టెక్నాలజీ 2008 లో స్థాపించిన కళాశాలలో ఎంబీఏ, నాక్ ఏ గ్రేడ్ మరియు ఐఎస్ఓ సర్టిఫికేషన్ సాధించిన మొట్టమొదటి కళాశాల శ్రీ ముత్తవరపు వెంకటేశ్వరరావు కాలేజ్ ఆఫ్ ఇంజనీరింగ్ అండ్ టెక్నాలజీ త్వరలో ఎటోనమస్ కాబోతుంది.
2014 లో ఐఎస్ఓ గుర్తింపు, 2015 లో రాష్ట్ర ప్రభుత్వంచే ఏ గ్రేడ్, 2016 లో నాక్ ఏ గ్రేడ్, ఇప్పుడు ఎంబీఏ సాధించిన సంస్థ శ్రీ ముత్తవరపు వెంకటేశ్వరరావు కాలేజ్ ఆఫ్ ఇంజనీరింగ్ అండ్ టెక్నాలజీ.
గుడ్ మార్నింగ్ స్టూడెంట్స్. So in the last class we have discussed about the Wien bridge oscillator, and now we are going to discuss about the Schmitt trigger circuit using our operational amplifier. So what is this Schmitt trigger? So Schmitt trigger, which is also called as a regenerative comparator, the main operation of this Schmitt trigger is nothing but a comparator. So in the last classes we have observed that how the op amp is going to act as a comparator. Now we are going to observe that how the op amp is going to work as a Schmitt trigger. So what is comparator we have observed, and now we are going to see that the comparator, how this comparator operation is performed. That is how this comparator operation will be carried out in case of a Schmitt trigger operation. So what happens, we are going to observe that how the op amp is going to behave as a Schmitt trigger. As we know that the Schmitt trigger is a circuit which is nothing but a regenerative comparator, so which is going to, the output of the Schmitt trigger is going to fluctuate between two voltage levels, that is a change between two voltage levels, nothing but the two voltage levels are nothing but plus Vsat and minus Vsat in case of operational amplifier. So we have observed the Schmitt trigger operation using a transistor in our previous subjects. So now in our linear IC application subject, we are going to observe the Schmitt trigger operation, how this Schmitt trigger operation has been performed by using this operational amplifier. So in this lecture itself, we are going to observe the transfer characteristics of this Schmitt trigger, how this transfer characteristics can be modified by using, can be modified using this using op amp we are going to observe here, and as well as what is hysteresis. So we are going to observe the theme about, that is hysteresis. We are going to know about the hysteresis, what is this hysteresis, so how this hysteresis can be changed for the Schmitt trigger, and we are going to study about the hysteresis. So as we know that our op amp can operate in two modes of operations, that is inverting mode as well as non-inverting mode. So we are going to observe both inverting mode of operation of op amp. So that is nothing but here how our operational amplifier is going to work as a inverting Schmitt trigger. So here we are going to consider input as inverting input, that whatever the signal we are giving is nothing but to a inverting input terminal of our operational amplifier. So if it is going to act as an inverting Schmitt trigger, we are going to see the analysis part of that Schmitt trigger. So how it is going to generate the output voltage, and how it is going to generate the output voltage with respect to the input voltage. So then we are going to observe the UTP, that is upper threshold point and lower threshold point regarding this Schmitt trigger circuit. So what will be the value, that UTP value, what will be the upper threshold value is going to depend upon which factors, as well as the lower threshold value is going to depend upon which factors. So we are going to see that, and also the transfer characteristics, how the transfer characteristics will be for this Schmitt trigger. We are going to observe the transfer characteristics, and we are going to observe the hysteresis in those transfer characteristics, and we are going to consider an example, and we are going to calculate the hysteresis in that example itself. And again, we are going to observe the Schmidt-Jager operation using non-inverting input. So for an operational amplifier, we are giving the input signal to the non-inverting input of op-amp, and then we are observing the output. So how the output is going to change when the input is applied to the non-inverting terminal of operational amplifier. So there will from this we are going to observe that the difference between inverting Schmidt trigger and non-inverting Schmidt trigger, and analysis of non-inverting Schmidt trigger, that is nothing but we are going to obtain the UTP and LTP values, that is upper threshold point as well as the lower threshold point of the Schmidt trigger values, and which factors those two UTP and LTP is going to depend upon, we are going to see. And then we are going to observe the transfer characteristics of the Schmidt trigger, that is a non-inverting Schmidt trigger. And finally, we are going to observe the applications. So at what places we are going to use this Schmidt trigger circuit, in which type of applications we are going to use this Schmidt trigger circuit, we are going to observe. So now we are going to see what is a Schmidt trigger and what is the analysis part of this Schmidt trigger. So carry on with this video.
You will understand what is this Schmidt trigger, what is the purpose of using this Schmidt trigger in electrical and electronic systems, and how it can be designed. Now in the last video of comparator, we have seen that it can be used to compare the two voltage levels. But the problem with this comparator is that if input signal is noisy, in that case, your output will be get affected and you will not get the desired output. So let's say we have one comparator, and to this comparator, we have applied these input signals V1 and V2. Now here, assume that this signal V1 is the input signal and this signal V2 is the reference signal, and assume that this signal are ideal signals. So in that case, as V1 is greater than V2, so you should get a constant high output voltage. But if this signal V1 is noisy, in that case, it is possible that it can affect your output voltage. So let's say because of the noise, this V1 signal looks like this. So if you observe this signal V1, then you can notice over here that this signal V1 crosses this signal V2 at these two locations. So for the time period for which this signal V1 is less than V2, for that duration, you will get a low voltage. So because of the noise, you will see the transition in the output voltage, or we can say that your output will be get affected because of the noise in this input signal. So we can say that this comparator is not immune to the noise, and because of that, it can affect your output. Now, this kind of problem can be avoided by using the Schmidt trigger. Now, the Schmidt trigger is nothing but the comparator with the hysteresis. It means that the Schmidt trigger has a two threshold voltages. One is the upper threshold voltage, that is for low to high transition, and second is the lower threshold voltage, that is for high to low transition. And this is the symbol of a Schmidt trigger. So now let us understand how this Schmidt trigger circuit works. So here, let us say the signal which is represented in a red color is the input signal, and this two are the upper and the lower threshold voltage for the given Schmidt trigger. So now let us see how the Schmidt trigger will respond to this given input signal. And here, let us assume that the initial voltage across this Schmidt trigger is zero. So as you can see over here, initially the input signal is zero and gradually it is increasing. So the output of this Schmidt trigger will remain low till the point this input signal crosses this upper threshold voltage. So up to this point, your output signal will remain zero. And from that point onward, your output signal will remain high. Now, if you observe over here, once this input signal crosses this upper threshold voltage, then after it deviates around this upper threshold voltage. But then also your output signal will remain high, and it will go to the low voltage only when this input signal goes below this lower threshold voltage. So at this point, once again, your output will become low, and it will remain low till the point once again this input signal crosses this upper threshold voltage. So again, at this point, your output will become high, and it will remain high after that point. So as you can see over here, even if your input signal varies around this upper and the lower threshold voltage, then also your output signal will not get changed and it will remain constant. So we can say that this mid trigger provides the noise immunity over this band, and the difference between this upper and the lower threshold voltage is known as the hysteresis voltage of the Schmitt trigger. So basically this hysteresis voltage defines the noise immunity of the given Schmitt trigger. So if you observe this example, there are four parameters which is required to define the Schmitt trigger. The first two are the high and the low output levels of the Schmitt trigger, and the remaining two are the upper and the lower threshold voltages, which will decide the triggering instant for the Schmitt trigger. So these four parameters defines the characteristic of the Schmitt triggers, and the characteristic of this Schmitt trigger graphically can be represented by this transfer characteristic curve. So here on the x-axis we have the input voltage and on the y-axis we have the output voltage. So now for the given example, let us draw the transfer characteristic of the Schmitt trigger. So if your input signal is less than the upper threshold voltage level of the Schmitt trigger, in that case your output will remain low, and as soon as it crosses this upper threshold voltage level, then your output will become high. And if the input signal goes beyond this upper threshold voltage level, then also your output will remain high. Now suppose if your input signal starts reducing, then also your output signal will remain high, and it will remain high till the point your input signal goes below this lower threshold voltage level. So as soon as your input signal goes below this lower threshold voltage, then again your output will become low voltage. And if your input signal goes below this lower threshold voltage, then also your output will remain low. So this is how the Schmitt trigger can be represented using this transfer characteristic. So this transfer characteristic is also known as the hysteresis curve for the Schmitt trigger. So now here, if your output voltage levels VH and VL are equal and opposite in polarity, in that case your transfer characteristic curve will be symmetric with respect to the y-axis. And by providing the reference voltage as an input to this Schmitt trigger, we can shift this curve either to the right or the left hand side. So for the Schmitt trigger which has this kind of transfer characteristic curve is known as the non-inverting Schmitt trigger, because here once your input signal crosses this upper threshold voltage level, then your output will become high. And when your input signal is less than this lower threshold voltage, at that time your output will become low. So we can say that this transfer characteristic curve is the curve for the non-inverting Schmitt trigger. Similarly, we can have a hysteresis curve for the inverting Schmitt trigger. So in case of this inverting Schmitt trigger, whenever your input signal is less than the upper threshold voltage level, at that time your output will be high. And once it crosses this upper threshold voltage level, then your output will become low voltage. And if we go beyond this upper threshold voltage level, then also your output will remain low. Now suppose this input signal starts reducing, then also your output will remain low, and it will remain low till the point your input signal crosses the lower threshold voltage level. So once this input signal crosses this lower threshold voltage level, then once again your output will become high. So this is the transfer characteristic curve of the inverting Schmitt trigger, and this curve can be shifted either to the right or left side by providing the external reference voltage as an input to this inverting Schmitt trigger. So this is the symbol of the inverting Schmitt trigger. So if you observe over here, the hysteresis curve inside this triangle is the hysteresis curve for the inverting Schmitt trigger, or it can be even represented by adding the bubble at the notch of the non-inverting Schmitt trigger. So now that is being said, now let us see how we can design this inverting and the non-inverting Schmitt triggers. So there are many ICs are available which can be directly used as a Schmitt trigger, but this Schmitt trigger can also be designed by using the op-amp and the comparators, or even it can be designed by using the transistors. So in this video, we will understand how this inverting and the non-inverting Schmitt triggers can be designed by using the op-amp. So this is the example of inverting Schmitt trigger which is being designed using the op-amp. So here the input is applied at the inverting terminal, and there is a positive feedback from output to the input side. So now let us understand how this circuit will act as an inverting Schmitt trigger. So here, assume that the voltage at this non-inverting terminal is equal to V plus. Now for this circuit, whenever your Vin is greater than V plus, at that time your output voltage will become low voltage, and whenever your Vin is less than V plus, at that time your output will be high. So first of all, let us find the expression for this V plus, and it can be found by applying the KCL at this node. So applying KCL, we can write this V plus minus 0 divided by R1 plus V plus minus V out divided by R2, that is equal to 0. That means the summation of these two current is equal to 0. And if we simplify it, then we will get the expression for the V plus as R1 divided by R1 plus R2 times this voltage V out. Now here, initially assume that the output of this mid trigger is equal to high voltage, that is VH. And in that condition, let us assume this voltage V plus, that is equal to V1. So we can write this voltage V1 as R1 divided by R1 plus R2 times this voltage VH. So when your input signal Vin is greater than this voltage V1, in that case, the output of this op-amp or the Schmitt trigger will become low voltage. So now whenever your input signal Vin is greater than this voltage V1, in that case, your output will become low. And this voltage V1 is known as the upper threshold voltage of this inverting Schmitt trigger. So we can say that the upper threshold voltage for the inverting Schmitt trigger is equal to R1 divided by R1 plus R2 times this voltage VH. Now, once this condition is satisfied, at that time, your output of this Schmitt trigger will become low voltage, and it will remain low till the point when this input signal Vin is less than this voltage V plus. Now, once the output of this Schmitt trigger is low, in that case, your V plus will become R1 divided by R1 plus R2 times this voltage VL. And let us say in this condition, this voltage V plus as V2. Now in this condition, the output of this mid trigger will become high only when this input signal Vin is less than this voltage V2. So whenever this condition is satisfied, at that time, the output of this Schmitt trigger will become again high. So this voltage V2 is known as the lower threshold voltage of the Schmitt trigger. So we can say that the lower threshold voltage of the Schmitt trigger is equal to R1 divided by R1 plus R2 times this voltage VL, and the upper threshold voltage is equal to R1 divided by R1 plus R2 times this voltage VH. And the difference between this upper and the lower threshold voltage is known as the hysteresis voltage of the Schmitt trigger. And basically, this hysteresis voltage defines the noise immunity of the Schmitt trigger. So let's say, for example, in this condition, the VH is equal to 12 volt and VL is equal to minus 12 volt and R1 is equal to R2 is equal to R. So in this condition, the upper threshold voltage for the given Schmitt trigger will become 6 volt and the lower threshold voltage will become minus 6 volt, and the hysteresis will be equal to 6 minus minus 6, that is equal to 12 volt. So in this way, we can design the inverting Schmitt trigger by using the op-amp. And we can even shift the transfer curve either right or to the left by providing the external reference voltage as an input to this inverting Schmitt trigger. So now that is being said, now let us see how we can design the non-inverting Schmitt trigger by using this op-amp. So here we have applied the input at the non-inverting terminal and there is a positive feedback from output to the input side. So now let us understand how this circuit will act as a non-inverting Schmitt trigger. So once again, assume that the voltage at this node is equal to V plus. And here if you observe, the inverting terminal is at a ground potential. So whenever the V plus is greater than zero, in that case, the output of this op-amp will be high. And whenever the V plus is less than zero, in that case, the output of the op-amp will be low. So first of all, let us find the expression for this voltage V plus. So once again, let us apply the KCL at this particular node. So applying KCL, we can write V plus minus V in divided by R1 plus V plus minus V out divided by R2, that is equal to zero. Or we can say that V plus multiplied by 1 divided by R1 plus 1 divided by R2, that is equal to V in divided by R1 plus V out divided by R2. And if we simplify it, then we will get the expression of V plus as R2 divided by R1 plus R2 times this input voltage V in plus R1 divided by R1 plus R2 times the voltage V out. So this is the expression of the V plus in terms of the input voltage and the output voltage. Now here, initially assume that the output of this op-amp is low, that is V out is equal to VL. And in that condition, let us say this voltage V plus as a voltage V1. So the expression of the VL will become R2 divided by R1 plus R2 times this input voltage V in plus R1 divided by R1 plus R2 times this voltage VL. So whenever this voltage V1 is greater than zero, in that case, the output of this op-amp will become high. So we can say that for this condition, R2 divided by R1 plus R2 times this Vin should be greater than minus VL multiplied by the R1 divided by R1 plus R2. Or we can say that Vin should be greater than minus R1 divided by R2 times this voltage VL. So whenever this condition is satisfied, in that case, the output of this op-amp will become high. So this voltage is known as the upper threshold voltage for the Schmitt trigger. So we can say that the upper threshold voltage is equal to minus R1 divided by R2 times this voltage VL. Now here we are assuming that the low voltage level for this op-amp is a negative. So if you see, the upper threshold voltage will become positive. So this is the expression of the upper threshold voltage for the non-inverting Schmitt trigger. So whenever this condition is satisfied, in that case, the output of the op-amp will become high. And once this output voltage will become high, in that condition, the expression for the voltage V plus will get changed. So in this condition, when the output voltage V out is high, then let us say the voltage V plus, that is equal to V2. And for this condition, the V2 will become R2 divided by R1 plus R2 times the input voltage V in plus R1 divided by R1 plus R2 times this voltage VH. So here basically we have replaced this output voltage V out by VH. So now in this condition, the output of this Schmitt trigger will become low only when this V2 is less than zero. So we can say that for this condition, this voltage R2 divided by R1 plus R2 times this V in should be less than minus R1 divided by R1 plus R2 times this voltage VH. Or we can say that the input voltage V in should be less than minus R1 divided by R2 times this voltage VH. So once this condition is satisfied, in that case, once again, the output of this Schmitt trigger will become low voltage. And for this input voltage for which this condition is satisfied is known as the lower threshold voltage for the non-inverting Schmitt trigger. So we can say that the lower threshold voltage is equal to minus R1 divided by R2 times the voltage VH. So in this way, the expression for the upper threshold voltage is equal to minus R1 divided by R2 times the voltage VL, and the expression for the lower threshold voltage is equal to minus R1 divided by R2 times the voltage VH. And here we are assuming that VH and VL are equal and opposite in the polarity. So in this way, we can design this non-inverting Schmitt trigger by using this op-amp. Now we can shift this transfer curve either to the right or left side by providing the external reference voltage. So if you provide the external reference voltage, then according to the polarity of this reference voltage, we can shift this transfer curve either to the right or to the left side. So in this way, using this op-amp circuit, we can design this inverting and the non-inverting Schmitt triggers. So this Schmitt trigger is particularly useful when we want to compare the two voltage levels, and we know that the input is a noisy. So this Schmitt trigger can be used as a level comparator, and it can be used in analog to digital conversions. Apart from that, this Schmitt trigger can be used as a wave shaping circuit. So if you have a sine wave or a triangular wave, and if you want to convert that wave into the square wave, then using the Schmitt trigger, we can convert it. Apart from that, if you observe over here, we are providing the positive feedback to the op-amp to design this Schmitt trigger. So using this Schmitt trigger, we can even design the multivibrator or the oscillator. So these are the few applications in which this Schmitt trigger can be used. So in the next video, we will take some examples, and through the examples, we will see the
So we have observed from this video, we have observed how the comparator is going to be changed as a Schmitt trigger, and the transfer characteristics of the Schmitt trigger, how we are going to obtain the hysteresis of the Schmitt trigger, and we have observed the operation of the inverting Schmitt trigger, as well as we have observed the operation and analysis, how to calculate, that is nothing but how to calculate the upper threshold value and lower threshold value of the Schmitt trigger, and we have observed the transfer characteristics and how to change the transfer characteristics, that is nothing but how to move the transfer characteristics by nothing but by changing the reference voltage. We can shift the hysteresis curve. So that also we have observed in this, and example how to calculate, in that example how to calculate the hysteresis and how to calculate the upper threshold value and how to calculate the lower threshold value we have observed, and how this Schmitt trigger is going to work when it is when the input is given to the non-inverting terminal. So here we have observed that the Schmitt trigger is provided with the positive feedback, and analysis of this non-inverting Schmitt trigger, we have calculated the values of UTP and LTP for this non-inverting Schmitt trigger, as well as we have observed the transfer characteristics of this non-inverting Schmitt trigger, and finally we have observed the applications of this Schmitt trigger. So where we are going to use this Schmitt trigger, we have observed. Thank you, students. Thank you.